hear that? Those are the bells of St. Michael's, and they haven't been played for a while.
25 feet long, 50 feet wide, and 30 feet high. Now it's made out of entirely Western red cedar, with the two exceptions of the Sitka spruce roof supporting beams that run the full length of the house, and also the yellow cedar stepping blocks you see here below. Now there's a few things you may have noticed while walking into the house. First of all, the floorboards were a little loose and wobbly. Well, this is because we built this house as traditionally as possible. This meaning not many screws or nails were used in the process of building this house. Now, the families were living here. This is where we lived in the old days. And how we would determine how much space each family got is we take the tallest man or woman that was living in the house, lay them down flat on their back, and how many boards they took up, that's how much space each family got. Now, another reason why the floorboards were a little loose is because we'd be able to lift them up, and then we'd store our belongings under, and we'd put the floorboards back. So, you guys may have walk-in closets. My ancestors had walk-on closets. Another thing you may have noticed are the levels. The more levels there are in a clan house, the more the wealthier that clan is. The bottom level will be filled in with gravel and sand that the children will change out 2 to 3 times a week. And this would be used as a fire pit. There'd be one large fire burning in the middle at a constant 24/7, used for heating purposes. Then there'd be 4 to 5 other little fires around that fire used for cooking purposes, as needed. Now this concludes my portion of the program. But before I turn it over, I do have a question for you. Wasayiki. I heard a couple of you say it, but what I was looking for was plate wasa. All right, wasayiki. All right, now I'm gonna turn it over to Kodek. He'll come out to you.
My name given to me at birth is Kudek. It's about an eagle that's flying really high across. Today, the Cape Fox tour dancers will perform a few of their songs and dances for you. On the very last one that we do, we're going to kind of throw a little invitation at you. And those of you that are willing to accept our invitation will ask to come on up here. We'll share regalia with you, and we'll have a good time together. But before we can do anything like that, we must ask the dancers that are behind the screen to come on out. So thank you for your kind attention. Let's get the dance up here. Thank you.
Thank you. waiting for this guy.
Our engine tools was jade, which we get from the jade deposit up in the Juneau area. Now, this isn't the jewelry jade you may be thinking of, it's a denser form of jade, so it's more durable to be able to use on our tools. Now the paints, there are three main colors of paint that carvers would use. That is a reddish brown, which came from iron oxide. The bluish green, which came from copper oxide or iron silicate. And then the black, which came from charcoal or coal. Now traditionally, on our totem poles, there'd be 6 to 8 feet on the bottom of it, uncarved, untouched, just played into raising the totem pole. And how we raise one, we dig a hole 6 to 8 feet in the ground, build an A-frame over it, and we hoist the totem up with cedar rope to the beat of a drum. And meanwhile, while that was going on, the head carver of the totem would be standing out to the side with this, or dancing out to the side with this tool belt on. Now, this did take a lot of men, as you can see in the picture up there. So potlatches were always held at the same time as the totem pole raised.
Hi, my name's Denny. I'm a Tlingit, and my clan is of the Raven Beaver. As I live here in Saxman. Unfortunately, I don't know any Tlingit words. I just know what you got. I teach you guys wasaiti, which means, or which is asking how you're doing. And klekwasa is the only answer I know, and that means I'm doing good or I'm doing fine. And then gunas chish is the most used phrase in the Tlingit language, which means thank you.